Hello everyone, welcome to PRV Solution. So in this experiment we will study measurement of attenuation. So firstly we will study the definition of attenuation. Attenuation is a measure of the reduction in the power level experienced by a signal as it passes through a circuit. So whenever a signal travels from one point to another point in a circuit, then there is reduction in power level takes place, and this reduction is known as attenuation. So in microwave components and devices often deliver some attenuation when connected in for measurement. So when we will connect microwave component and devices for measurement purpose, they also produces some level of attenuation in the circuit. The amount of attenuation offered can be dignified in two ways. So we can measure this attenuation by two ways. First method is power ratio method, and the second method is RF substitution method. So attenuation mathematically defined as the ratio of the input power to the output power, and it is mostly or normally expressed in decibels. So attenuation in decibels is given as 10 log P in by P out, where P in is the input power and P out is the output power. So now we will see how power ratio method is used for measurement of the attenuation. So in this technique, measurement of attenuation takes place in two steps. So here we will use two steps. In step one, the input and the output power of the whole microwave bench is done without device whose attenuation has to be calculated. And the second method, the input and output power of the whole microwave bench is done with the device whose attenuation has to be calculated. So in first step, we will connect our device, and in second step we will connect our device. The ratio of these power when compared gives the value of attenuations, and the resulting figures are the two steps which clarify this. So here device is not connected, microwave source is connected, attenuator is connected, frequency meter is connected, throttle end is connected, termination is connected, and this is the power meter is connected through crystal detector. And in second step, we will use our device under test whose attenuation is to be measured. So now in step two, we will connect these device whose attenuation is to be measured. So in another diagram we can see here attenuation in dB is given by 10 log P2 by P1. What is P1? P1 is with DUT, means P1 is the output power which is indicated by this power indicator when device under test is connected in the bench, and P2 is the power in the power meter without device under test is connected. So attenuation is in decibel is given by 10 log P2 by P1. P2 is the power without DUT and P1 is the power with DUT. DUT is device under test. So in this way we can measure attenuation in the using power ratio method. If power meter is not available here, power meter is not available, we can use CRO or multimeter. Why CRO or multimeter is used? Because the detector of the probe obey always square law, means P1 by P2 is equal to V1 by V2 is equal to I1 by I2, because the output from the detector is the square of the voltage or square of the current, and square of the voltage is equals to the power. But this method has drawbacks. What is the drawback of this method? Drawback is the power and the attenuation measurement may not be accurate here, because when the input power is low, attenuation of the network may be large. This is due to this point. This method uses two different points on the characteristic curve of the diode detector, at which the detector may not be obey square characteristics, leading erroneous readings. So here we will use two different points on the scala curve, P1 and P2. So due to these two points, it will lead to erroneous results in the experiment. So this drawback can be removed by using another method, which is known as RF substitution method. And here we will use three steps. In step one, the output power of the whole microwave bench is measured with the network whose attenuation has to be calculated. Means we will use here device under test, and then we will measure this output power. Now in second step, the output power of the whole microwave bench is measured by replacing the network with a precision calibrated attenuator. In second step, we will change this network with the standard variable precision attenuator. This is the standard variable precision attenuator. And in step 3, this attenuator is now adjusted to obtain the same power as measured with the network. Now for example, suppose some power is coming when device under test is connected, and now we will change this or replace this device under test with a variable precision attenuator, and now the power may be differed, and now we will adjust this attenuator so that it will this setup will give the same output power which is given in step 1. So this reading of precision attenuator is now the attenuation of the device whose attenuation we want to be measured. So the adjusted value on the attenuator provides the attenuation of the network openly. So in this way we can calculate the attenuation of in the microwave bench. Thanks for watching.